Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes with Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today I want to talk about performance cliffs encountered with multi-exact transaction IDs. We'll start with this blog post by Christophe Pettus, who writes about a foreign key pathology to avoid. And this involves foreign keys causing multi-exact problems in Postgres. He starts by describing a system that's kind of like Twitch, where we have a table called stream, a table called user, and a table called stream viewer. A stream viewer has a stream ID and a user ID. The idea is when somebody starts viewing a stream, we keep track of that in the stream viewer table. We are using foreign keys here, which oftentimes is a good practice in Postgres for consistency reasons. But here they do cause a performance problem that is surprising. Now let's say a very popular streamer onboards their platform and they start streaming. Suddenly 1.2 million people want to watch that stream. That is probably a small stream on Twitch these days. When they log on and they start following the stream, the way that this data model is set up will do inserts on the stream viewer table. Now that in itself, inserting 1.2 million records at the exact same time will cause some contention in Postgres. However, that's not really the issue. The big issue is that we have all these records who have a foreign key relationship to a single record in the stream table. What Postgres does when you have a foreign key like this, it will hold a four key share lock on the stream row, in this case, on that single row that we're referencing. And Postgres holds this lock so that the stream row, in this case, doesn't just disappear whilst we're inserting the stream viewers. That's important to guarantee consistency of the foreign key relationship. However, the way that Postgres keeps track of these locks is what causes the issues here. When more than one transaction holds lock on a single record, a single row, then the multi-exact system in Postgres handles that. Multi-execs are assigning a special transaction ID to the row that's being locked. And then there's an external data structure that keeps track of all the multiple transaction IDs that are actually referencing that record. The row is a fixed size structure, so you can't just keep adding these IDs to that local row information. So that's why there's a separate data structure that keeps track of this. This generally works quite all right, but the problem is once you have a high number of transaction IDs that are doing this, then it's a big problem. It can fill up a local cache essentially and spill to a secondary storage. Now that will be slow. And what you will see is that suddenly a lot of connections will wait on these multi-exact lightweight locks. This is what we show in your wait events view, or just if you look at pgset activity. The way that Christophe recommends you deal with this type of situation is that you actually reconsider whether you should have foreign keys, because foreign keys in a situation like this are a problem. And you may actually opt to not have these same consistency requirements based on this workload. The other thing that Christophe recommends here, which I think makes a lot of sense, is that you think about when transaction IDs are assigned. And so if you're able to batch things together, maybe you can make it one big transaction or several big transactions instead of 1.2 million transactions. Because really that's what's causing the problem here. So you're doing single inserts instead of a batch insert. Now you may think that this is an obscure problem, but there is a popular post from Nelson Elhage that also was referenced in a GitLab postmortem quite a while ago, where Nelson had described at another company where he ran into a problem on a production database where he suddenly saw performance spiking and performance behaving quite oddly. First of all, they saw the query latency on a database spiking and the throughput just plummeted to essentially nothing. The database would essentially seem to lock up. They look at pgset activity and other tools, and what they would see is LWLock, and then it would see multi-exact being the wait event type. This means that they saw a multi-exact problem, they just didn't really know what that was. After more investigation, they discovered this multi-exact behavior in Postgres. The one thing that I would add to what was mentioned in Christophe's post is that vacuuming is also important. What Nelson notes here is that this multi-exact ID that's being assigned is an actual number. Postgres actually has to clean up those numbers that are written to the rows in the table at some point. That occurs with the Postgres vacuum and autovacuum process. You can see more about this in the Postgres documentation, where it talks about multi-exacts and how the same way the transaction ID wraparound is a problem, multi-exact ID wraparound is also a problem. You may be surprised to see an anti-wraparound vacuum on your database, and if you're using multi-exacts, it could actually be a multi-exact anti-wraparound, not a regular transaction ID anti-wraparound. It's something to keep a close eye on if you know you're using a lot of multi-exact IDs. You can track that the same way you would track a transaction ID wraparound type problem. There's also the autovacuum multi-exact freeze max age setting as noted by the Postgres documentation, which controls when this freezing that happens for multi-exact reason actually occurs. Something to watch out for if you're using a lot of row-level locks. In that case, tune some of these settings potentially, or change your workload if you can. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.